the extra minutes you use in helping your child out of a present challenge count a lot. Welcome to Parenting Essentials. This is the home of key strategies to parenting. You are welcome. Do you know that as parents, the extra time we use on our children on any challenge they might be facing, it's a great help. This brings me to my childhood story. My father of blessed memory. Oh, I love my dad. He just passed away about 5 months ago. I remember growing up, and I think I should be around 5-6 years at this particular time. And I used to be part of the people that call ow, ow. I couldn't call her. At that particular time, my dad's always off and on, like going to work for 3 months, coming back. But in the midst of this, he was able to find time to train me how I'm able to call the sound hard today. And he taught me with a rhyme, you know. And I remember him helping out a lot of children around our neighborhood at that particular time. And this, he used a rhyme in my local language to teach me. And if I remember today, I was like, oh my, his time paid off. His extra 30 minutes teaching me on how to improve on the sound paid at the end of the day. And for those of you who understand my language, I used to say, mo ferra kara, only 5 naira. Eban if you brown paper, wrap it. So this is in a local language, but I don't know what challenge your child might be passing through. Is it the same sound? Why not just you make a rhyme and use my daddy's method and teach your child to come out of that sound she's trying to call or finding it difficult to do? It's gonna be a great one. So I just thought I should just give you that tip today because I'm a beneficiary of my dad's extra 30 minutes in teaching me how. So go ahead, help your child. Your child might be having challenges with the steps, maybe walking, whatever it is. Just find extra time. You are your child's first therapist before you can look for any help outside. You as a parent, you have to do your part first. And I believe this time is not going to be a waste of time. It's going to pay off. So today, I'm going to be talking about focusing on your child's strength and to share my experience. So I just want to advise parents that you should just concentrate on your child's strength. Try as much as possible to find out your child's interest and just dwell on it. Take advantage of it and help your child to grow the strength. Instead of you dwelling on your child's weakness, why not just forget about that and concentrate on your child's strength? I remember when I was growing up, I was this talkative girl, you know. Anyone around me could remember, you know, maybe my aunties and everyone, they used to call me the talkative girl. Like, literally, I talk. You know, when you say I talk, it's an understatement. I was a super duper talkative child. And I want to always contribute. I want to be part of every discussion. And in the community and in my culture, it's a kind of what is called the rude one, you know? You're not expected to talk when others are talking. And I remember being shunned several times, being shut up, like, keep quiet, you're not supposed to talk now. It was a lot of psychological issue for me growing up. And this is not just for my parents only, because in my tribe, everyone has a right to correct you, to train you. I just love to talk to grown-ups. I like to give my own advice. Even though at that particular time, I look at myself and say, how did you get to know those things? I couldn't even explain. Even till now, I can't really figure out. There's some things that I got to know that I can't really figure out how and where I learned them from. However, that is not the point today. The point today is you taking advantage of your child's strength. Looking back today, I realized that those were my strength that was not taken. So imagine if this advantage has been taken, like, let me just go into talking. Looking back, the truth is that I don't have any trait of an engineer. I just feel, okay, I can do it, I can be an engineer, but I went through it in school. That's story for another day. If there's something that I'm always grateful for, that going to that preparation, going for engineering, is the love of my life. If there's something the Lord has given to me in that my university days, it's finding the best husband in the world. The Lord blessed me with my sweet darling husband. So anytime I want to say, oh my goodness, I just wasted my time, then I remember, oh, you didn't waste your time. You actually found that man in that same department, even though it was almost quarter to the end of him leaving the school. Let me come back to my point today. My point today is, concentrate on your children's strength. My point today is, you should concentrate on your children's strength rather than dwelling on their weakness. Your child cannot do everything, even though if that is what you want. But why not just take your time and study the unique child? What are the strengths? What gives her energy? What gives him energy? Take the advantage and just push your child in that direction. I know, even if I look back today, I've always been that child who want to counsel grown up. I've always been that child who want to teach. I've always been that child who loves to be around kids. I've been helping out in raising children right from my high school. You know, there were indications here and there that this is what I'm called to do. And another thing is the environmental factor. You know, growing up those days, somebody should tell you to go and do education. If someone should tell you, you're very good, you're a good teacher, go to college of education, it's like, are you serious? Is that a course? You feel like this is not a good wish for you. I remember when I went for my NYSC, this is a program that you do when you finish your university program in Nigeria, like you want to serve your nation for 1 year. And I was posted to a school. All the report I got from the teachers at that moment was, you're born to be a teacher, you're a teacher. But I was like, oh my goodness. It took me a very long time to accept who I am. Why? I think because of the environmental factor. They look down on teachers. I know I'm always a teacher, but it took me time to accept and to take it up as a career and to pursue my dream. So in all this, me sharing my story with you is not to bore you, but for you to know that it's very important for you to take advantage of your child's strength and support your child in pursuing your child's dream. So, stop dwelling on your child's weakness. My child cannot sing very well. Your child doesn't have to sing. My child doesn't like to play football. Your child might not be a footballer. My child doesn't like to talk to people. She's just shy. She's just inside reading. Why not just do something in line with reading? Just search. Take your time. It's very, very important. If you have not done that, I want to encourage every parent who is seeing this video right now. It's a plea from me, or a liar to you. I'm pleading to every parent who is seeing this video right now. Yes, you, mommy and daddy. Please, take a moment and find out what is the unique thing about your child. Find out the unique child, the strength of your child, and please help your child to grow his strength. Help your child to grow a strength. It is very important. I wouldn't want your child to grow up and have similar story like mine, because the advantage of my strength wasn't taken properly. Don't get me wrong, I love my parents. I am not saying they didn't do well. For you to know, my mom is not learned. She's not educated. My daddy is just halfway there. So, and he was not always around. So she did all she could do. She's the best mother in the world, and she's the best I can always ask for. Thank God for who we are today, and that is why we are trying to get better. We want to be a better parent to our children. So why not you take advantage of your child's strength today? Anyways, I went to school, university, and I studied electrical electronics. I know my classmates might be seeing this video and smile now. You know, looking back, I'll just smile. And I became like, woo, okay. But however, the good thing is, there's always something good out of everything. So for my own story, my own good news is, God gave me my husband from that department. And my husband is the best I can always ask for. So I'm always grateful to him. So anytime I want to remember that, I say, oh my goodness, now I have to study all this. I have to go and do this training. I have to go and do this course. Anytime I want to have the feeling of, oh my goodness, I wasted my 5 years in the university, then I'll say, this is sounding being ungrateful. I am grateful to God. I mean, I'm a believer of God, and I believe so much in everything that happened to a child of God is for a purpose. And please, the whole purpose of sharing my story today is for you to find out the unique child, understand your child's strength, to push forward in using the strength in the right path. Thank you for joining me today. I believe you've been able to learn one or two things from my story, and more stories to come. We're still going to be talking about growing up. All right, for parents, who are ready to utilize their child's strength, I give you a high five. Come on. I'll see you again next week on another wonderful episode on Parenting Essentials. If you're just seeing my face for the first time, my name is Oye, Oye Layo, and I am your parenting coach. And all the Vision Guide videos are available on the Vision Guide YouTube channel. Make sure you subscribe, show me some love, remember to share, comment, and like. Thank you for all of you who have been sharing. I know I'm so grateful. It's so wonderful to see a lot of people share our videos. We are so grateful and we're not taking it for granted. And I hope you check all our videos out on our YouTube. There are many more goodies on our YouTube channel. Don't miss out. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button if you have not done so. And keep sharing. Click the like button and comment, comment, comment. I'll see you again next week. It's December. Let's rejoice because we are alive. See you again next time.